What are you looking at?
I got a brand new fleet of 08 Articats. Got a bunch of help from some of the industry's coolest aftermarket companies. We've got one stock M8 and one stock M1000, and then we have stage one and stage two. These are all sleds that are gonna be ridden by the clients. We did all speedwork stuff on the mod sleds, built by Eric at Voke Performance. Signed Jeremy up, and he brought a couple, I guess I'll call them flatliners, because they kind of have an accent, kind of, you know, from that way. We went and found some pretty awesome snow already today, and now we're gonna tune the sleds up a little bit more and go have a good time.
The motor itself appears to be just a stock 800 with a Boondocker turbo kit on it, and one of our Speedwork Y pipes and single pipes that we're doing a bunch of development on with Eric at Alpine and Chris.
It's like a $30,000 snowmobile, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. But
and when you watch it go up the hill, you'll know why it costs $30,000.
It's just, it's so gnarly. Like, people aren't ready for this.
Roughly at about 9,000 to 10,000 feet. And today we are doing a bunch of product testing on the 08 Articat M8 sleds. And we have all four stages of our performance levels that that we offer. What we've got here is a 2008 stock M8. It is reclutched to be ridden at this elevation, 9,000 to 10,000 feet. From there, this is basically our baseline setup for the testing we're gonna be doing. All the comparisons and everything we do once we think we got something that works good. This is what we compare it to make sure we are doing better, you know, or making it better. This is what we let the producer ride so it doesn't get away from him. Here we basically have our stage one kit. It's got one of Eric's lightweight high flow intakes on it, our Speedworks Y pipe, single pipe and lightweight muffler. It's reclutched, and the 08 models require a Boondocker fuel controller. This is what we classify as our stage one kit. It's an entry level, it's good, it's safe, it's reliable, but it'll outperform a stock sled all day long.
Actually, what we're here to do is prove just what he said, that it will outperform a stock sled. So we're gonna run it through a series of comparative tests, both drag racing on flats in untracked snow, which you'll see a little later, and then in some climbs. And I think that's really the key thing, is trying to meet the use demand of the rider out here. Everybody rides a little different, and we're trying to make sure these packages work for everybody.
It's gonna be a fun year on these bad boys.
This unit, it's very similar in terms of the exhaust setup and the intake setup that you'll see on the stage one kit. However, to this we have added an additional high compression head and cylinder porting, and of course clutching to match those. Again, utilizing the Boondocker fuel control to meet the fuel demands, and this should be markedly faster than the stage one kit. This would be considered a stage two kit.
And what we've got here is stage four. This is these guys' pride and joy. I can't wait to ride this thing myself. I got to see it in action a little bit yesterday. This thing is really bad.
Yeah, what we've got is basically a combination of a kit that we've worked with Boondocker on. This is employing a Garrett-based turbo kit and an intercooler. And we've been working with Jeremy all year to develop an exhaust system that favors better runability for the turbo sleds. As turbo popularity has increased, we've found that we're gonna have to meet the demands, again, of the customers, and that's what we're trying to do with this package.
A lot of this stuff, like the pipe itself, these are in early stages of development. I mean, this is stuff that's gonna be available later on in the year.
And my role is to show people how insane and how ridiculous these things are, and that's what we're gonna do today. Yeah, I mean, this is a 445-pound snowmobile with 275 horsepower, and You put that power to weight to anything, and it's gonna be insane, and I get to do it on the snow.
Everything went as planned. We're gonna keep messing with stuff. I mean, our fuel settings and stuff are still a little bit off. I mean, we just rode a little bit this morning and a little bit last night. So, I mean, by the end of the day, we should have stuff dialed in pretty good. There's good powder, and we can pack it down to simulate hard pack conditions too. So the conditions are pretty much ideal here, you know.
I already see a progression from yesterday, and I'll see a progression tomorrow, and that's the biggest key is getting on these Articats, and they're just the easiest sled to ride, and they're a blast. You know, I try to explain to people what it's like to ride this turbo, and you just can't. What you don't understand is that it gets to a point when your skis are, you know, 6 feet off the ground, and you don't want to let off because you'll come down hard, but at the same time, you're about to loop out, so it is going to challenge my ability this year, and I cannot wait to see some of the things this thing's gonna do.
Yeah, let's see how launch is. You know, as part of our SpeedWorks package, we were thinking about mounting a temp probe in the hot dog and see whether our burritos are done yet when it's lunchtime, but we'll just see here. Have to question whether it's steaming or not steaming. Oh yeah, that's lunch.